Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a gecko on the rainbow loom. This one, I used eye beads that I found in a craft store that are in the bead section. And he has olive green toe pads and the light green for the body. And they also have extensions in the middle. And a new technique that I used to bring the head a little bit more rounded, 3D-ish. And this one, I just, instead of using a solid color, I did every other color. So this is fuchsia and black. And I made the toe pads the black color, so it stands out a little bit more. And he has green eyes for rubber bands. You can also use pony beads or any kind of bead you want for this reptile. They're super cute and they can also stand. You can pose him to stand just like that and he'll stand up, and you can make his body a little bit more rounded so he's a little bit more off the ground. So, but he's really cute and it's a single loom, and we're going to make him in a couple different parts. We're going to do the tail first, and you'll need a toothpick or an extra hook to hold the tail. Then we're going to make this section to make the a little bit more poofy on the head, and you have to use another toothpick to put it to the side. So, and then we'll make the body and then the legs on the hook. So let's get started. You will need a single loom. I'm going to use this pattern with a little color in the middle and the color on the toes. If you want to use this, it's just every other band was a different color. So you have fuchsia, black, like that. So I'm going to use orange for the middle color and the pads, and orange eyes with the green body. Okay, so we're going to make the tail first, and I'm going to use the green. And put it, it's gonna be arrows facing down, and then the camera's to the right, and it's double bands. So we're gonna go three bands across. Okay, then another band going diagonal. Then two more going regular. Okay, and then we're going to do just two pins. Okay, another two. We're just making his tail a little longer. Okay, another diagonal. Then going up. And then we're going to go two more going down. Okay, and now your capping band is a single wrap three times around. Now we're going to make a little some structural bands to hold everything together. You need a single band, twist it upon itself, and then place it connecting these two pins. Another single band, twist upon itself, connect these two pins. Another single band connected upon itself right here. And then this is a single. You want to place it just as so, and then wrap it around. It's going to be a single twist. Then twist it and place it just like that. So it's one and a half twists. So it goes around. I'll show you again. So place it on the hook, twist it, and then place it back around just like that. Now we can start looming forward. Okay, now we're grabbing this band. And then the diagonal, then I'm going to loom all the way forward. Okay, now we're going to loom up to this point. Okay, now we're grabbing this band because it's on the top. And looming forward. Now we'll go to diagonal. And the last. Okay, now you can take this slowly off the hook. I'm going to just place it on my hook right now. This is when you need a spare hook or the toothpicks. So I'm going to grab my toothpicks and I'm going to place it right through to save these. Okay, and that's your tail. Okay, just like that. Okay, so now I'm going to make the poofy part of the head. So it's a part of the head that I'm going to place on later on. So I'm going to use the same colors as the head that I'm using. Now, this one is black and fuchsia, but for the poofy part, I just used the fuchsia colors. So if you want your other colors to be darker, you can place that here too. So whatever you like, but I'm going to use the green and still double bands. I'm placing two there, then there, and then there. So it's straight across. Then we're going down to the middle pin. And then here to the middle pin. So your capping band will be a single wrapped three times around. And we're just going to loom everything forward and get a toothpick ready or another hook. So we're going to grab this one first. All the way up. Now we're going to grab this one. Go all the way up. Now grab this one. And all the way up. We'll take it off the loom. Grab my toothpick and place it through. Okay, and then save this for later, just like the tail. So now we can work on the body, and mine's going to be the green for the whole body. So it's double, and I'm going to place it right on the first pin to the right. And this is the head we're working on now. And then we're going to place another right here to this pin. And then we're going to work our way down. So everything is double. And if you're doing every other, you can work with that too. For here, I use the fuchsia for these two bands and fuchsia for here, and then I use black for here and black for here, and then I did every other. do another double here, and then we're going to do another row here. Okay, now we're going to go on a diagonal to go into the neck area. Okay, then we're going to go another two pin bars down. This is the neck. Okay, now we're working on the top part of the body, which is right here. And I'm going to make a belly like this, but an orange. But if you're making the every other, you can just do the every other two. And there is an extension in the belly area because it's four pin bars wide in this little belly area. Okay, so I'm gonna do the green, the outside. And then I'm gonna work on the orange for the inside. And then another green on the side. Okay, so now I'm going to just work all the way down with green on the left side. If I'm going too fast, you can slow down, put pause. Okay, now I'm working on the right side, the green. Okay, so now I'm going to work on the orange middle. And I'm going to place doubles going all the way down until this pin bar. Then I'm going to put a green right here at the end. Okay, so now I'm going to work on the middle extension to make him a little bit more wider in the middle. So I'm going to start right here. Take it slow if this is new to you with the extensions. I'm going to work not on this pin. I'm going to work on this pin. I'm going to place a double band right on top, then another double band, working my way down. So I'm laying another row on top. Then I'm going to place another double on top here and not over here. So I'm going to make a little capping band here of orange because the color of my belly. Wrap it around three times. Okay, just like that. So you have one, two, three, four. Okay, on four bands on top. Four double bands. Then I'm going to place little structural bands. It's a single. And I'm just going to place it right across the top. Another single, right across the top. Another single, right across the top. Single, across the top. single across the top, and then right here is a single twist just like the other one, which is a single, and I'm going to twist it halfway and place it like that. So it's a single, and then I twist it on top. Here, I'll show you again just like before. Single twist and right on top. Very easy. So we're going to loom this little extension. I'm not looming the bottom row. I'm only looming this top. So I'm going to go underneath that little capping band, grab the top bands that I put on there, and loom it forward. Then I'm going to grab just the top, loom it forward. Just the top, loom it forward, top, and then stop. Because this is not enough, this is a bottom. Okay, remember we only had these, the middle section. So we have one on the bottom here, one on the bottom here. Now we can grab this top little extension and pull it to the side. Top extension, pull to the side. Top extension, pull to the side, so it looks like this. Okay, now we can put the tail on here. So take your tail that you had before, you can take it off the holder, put the left side on this pin, put the middle here and the right side on here. So it just looks like that. Now I'm going to work with the legs. And I'm going to use the same color. I used olive green for these. If the back legs are one stitch bigger than the front, if you like your gecko to have big feet on both, you can use the back legs for the front legs too. But I use smaller for the front and bigger for the left, for the back. There's all kinds of different species of gecko, so you can have as, you know, they have different size feet. So I'm going to use a single orange, wrap it around my hook, and I'm making the back feet first. Four times. Then I'm going to take the color of my gecko, and I'm going to make a single, twist it upon itself, place it on your hook, bring that little toe pad forward, and it looks like that. Then I take another single green, twist it upon itself, place it on the hook, and here is one digit. We're going to make four of these. So take another orange, keep this on the hook too, wrap it around four times, then take your two single greens, twist, place it on the hook, just like that. Do another single green, and place it. So now I have two. So I'm going to make two more. Single wrapped four times around. And a single twisted green, and then another single twisted green, okay, another orange, four times, okay, two more singles, twists, place it just like that, another single twist, and it looks just like that. Okay, so now I take a single, we're gonna combine these and make a foot now. Make a single, twist it upon itself, then place it on your hook and bring all of the little toes on here, just like that. Okay, then grab the other end, place it on your hook. So now you have a little foot. Now I'm going to take a double of my green and place this on my double. Okay, then I'm going to take another double. And place that just like that. And then finally, one more double. Okay, so we have one back leg. And here's the olive green compared to the orange. And it is 3 stitches long. So 1, 2, 3. So you can move your toes to be more equaled out. And that's one back leg. So I'm gonna grab, I'm gonna make another back leg right now. So we'll place this guy right here. And same process, single, wrapped 4 times. Then a single twist. And I'm gonna make this one a little bit faster than the first one. Okay, here's one toe. Here's orange wrapped 4 times. Single twist. If I'm going too fast, you can pause and stop and rewind. Here's another single twist. So now I have 2. Make another 4 times around. Single twist of green. And another. So we have 3 so far, we need 1 more. Okay, and you have 4 toes right here. Now we're going to take your single twist and place the toes to make your foot. And just like that. Now we're going to do 3 sets of double bands. There's 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and you can move the band so it's more equal. And here are your hind legs. So we're going to place the legs right at the bottom. On here's 1, 2, 3 from up. The third pin from the bottom. Okay, now I'm going to place another one over here. Okay, third pin up. And it's the same level as your little extension. So now we're going to make the arms, which is a little bit smaller, but if you want them the same size as the back legs, then you can repeat the back leg stitches. But I'm going to make it just a little tad smaller. So you can take another single, twist four times, then another single twist for your green, and place it like that. So I'm not adding a second stitch for this one. Then take another single of the orange, or whatever color you're using, four times around, single twist, and number two is ready. And we're doing four again. Single twist, and then one more. Four, and then single twist again. So now you have four little toes. I'm going to do the same technique as before. Single twist, place it on your hook, and place your toes right on there. Okay, so now you have a little hand. Then I'm going to grab a double. It's going to be the same as before, a double. Place it just like that. Another double. And then another double. And we're going to place these right here, right on this diagonal pin. Okay, I'm going to make another set right here. So I'm going to put my oranges here. So I'm going to wrap four times around. Single twist. Single wrap four times around. Oops. Single twist. Another single wrap four. Single twist. Four, and then another single twist. Okay, now I'm going to grab a single, twist it, and place them on there, on that single twist. And here's one hand, then a double. Another double, and finally another double. And place it right here. Okay, so this is your little layout for the bottom part. Now we're going to work on the head, and I'm going to grab the section that we made before, and I'm going to place them right on these three pins. Okay, so you can take the first section off, place those bands right on this pin, so one, two, second pin down. Then we're going to grab this middle section and place it here and take it both off. I'm going to put this section on the third pin. Oops, that came off. So let me just put that here. So it's a great way to fix it too on camera. Okay, so I have the first section, second section. My third section came off. So I'm going to grab the bands. Place it through. These are the bands. Grab the section, the bands that came off, and just pull it right through. And place it back on the loop. And easy fix. So I'm going to keep this right here, keep this little bunch of bands here, because this is going to create this little bump in his head. Okay, now we can work on the eyes. I got these beads from a craft store. You can also use pony beads and color in the pupil. I'm going to just use bands for this one because everybody has the bands. Some people don't have the beads. So I'm going to grab a double and I'm going to wrap it around my hook four times. So one, two, three, and four. Then I'm going to grab another double and four times. Four. Now I'm going to use the same color as my body. So I'm going to take a single, place the little eyes on that single. And there's my eyes. Now I'm going to place the eyes a little bit differently because the eyes stay on this side of the head. So I'm going to place it on this pin, so one, two, three, place that, the end band here, then I'm going to place my eye right here, wrap it around, it stretches the bands out, and then place the other section right here. So it looks like that. So I put it here, wrapped it around, and place it here. Now we're going to do the structural bands for the neck now, and then we're ready to loom. So single, twist it again, and place it right here. Single, twist, place it there. Single, twist, place it here. This is another single and a half, like we were doing before. So single, twist, and another like little half right here. So single and then bring it around. And this is your layout. So you can pause it, see if yours looks like mine, and now we can start looming. And remember, this is to the side. It's going to be very easy. We're just going to loom this straight to this pin. And then we're going to loom this straight to this pin. And then this one to this pin. And then we'll work on the head. It's easy. So push these pins down. And then we're just grabbing this band. We're just looming forward. Drop all the way down. And we're going forward. that down so you get the bottom bands. And you can stop right there. You can loop forward, but I just want to stop right here to go a little slower. So now I'm going to work on the middle. I'm not touching these bands. We're just going the bottom bands going forward. Okay, so go all the way on the bottom, bring it forward. Same here. And the last one. Just like that. Now we're going to work on the left side. Under, right on the bottom. Then we're going to do the diagonal, which is the bottom band. Bring that forward. Now we're going to grab this band. It's all the way at the bottom. Okay, now we're going to grab this band. Now we'll grab this band. And finally this one. I'm going to loop this side all the way up to this pin, and then I'm going to loop this one to this pin. It's very crucial to stop at these because we're going to work with this little puffy part too and make it perfect for the gecko. So make sure you stop here. Okay, make sure this eye is to the side. Now we're going to grab this band, it's on the top. Okay, stop right here. Then we're going to grab this diagonal. And stop right there. So now we have this little puffy part to work with, and you can see the bottom of the bands are right here. The little puffy part is here, and then the top is right here. We want the little puffy part section to go over. So I'll show you really, try to go close. We're gonna grab those bands and bring it over. Just the little puffy part section that we've added. It should be around 4 bands. Okay, so it's just you bring that little puff over. Then we're going to grab this section, the puff. And there's one more little band in there hiding. Okay, just like that. Then we're gonna grab that section, bring it over. In there. So I grabbed all those little, puffy part and grabbed it over. Now I can loom forward these 3 stitches. okay, to the top. To the top. And one more over here. Okay, so now I'm going to loom this stitch to the middle. And then this stitch to the middle. And I'm going to grab a double band of green. Make a little slip knot. Pull it taut, and this is what it should look like. So this is the looped version of your gecko. Make sure it looks like this, the teardrop shapes, and can slowly take it off the loom. Okay, the head part, make it slow because there's a couple extra bands in the head. Okay, so now the middle part, take it off with the hook. Okay, so you want to hide these bands that are hanging. So I just place it on my hook and pull it through once. Then I go with the hook again, place it, the excess bands on there again, and pull it through just to hide the inside. Okay, so now we can stretch it. You push with your fingers that little puffy part that we did before, and it's going to come out. And you can see the little bands that we pulled over, they're straight on the bottom. So just push it up a little bit. The eyes, there's one band, there's a double band right here. I just like to pull that underneath so it brings the eye a little bit out. And then there's another on this side, see that band, hiding it, put it under, so it's right in the middle of that stitch. Make it straight, the body. It's your legs, and now he's very flat right now. I like to make him a little standing, a little bit off the ground. So what I do is, right here, there's a stitch on the shoulder. You can place your hook right through it, pull it up, bring the arm through it, and now the arm is in the front. So you can see this difference. With that one little technique, I brought the arm forward instead of the side. So here is this little stitch. I'm going to bring it up. Pull the arm through it, and now he's in the front, in the forward position. I'm going to do the same thing with the back legs. So here's a little stitch right here, his back leg. Pull it through and just bring his leg through. Okay, you see what a big difference that is? These three are done and this one's still flat. So I'm going to grab that little stitch again. pull the leg through, and now they're in the front. Pull the leg, the tail straight. Now you can move him around, stretch out the legs, make the pads more straight. You can bend this a little bit too. And you have a cute little gecko. And then if you want his head a little bit up, you just move it up. The bands will adjust. Just like that. And you have a gecko. So I really hope you like this tutorial. Here's the other one. So now we have orange and the olive green. And then I love this one, the multicolored. So I hope you like this tutorial. Please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs. See you soon. Hello, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a gecko on the rainbow loom. This one, I used eye beads that I found in a craft store that are in the bead section. And he has olive green toe pads and the light green for the body. And they also have extensions in the middle. And a new technique that I used to bring the head a little bit more rounded, 3D-ish. And this one, I just, instead of using a solid color, I did every other color. So this is fuchsia and black. And I made the toe pads the black color, so it stands out a little bit more. And he has green eyes for rubber bands. You can also use pony beads or any kind of bead you want for this reptile. They're super cute, and they can also stand. You can pose him to stand just like that, and he'll stand up. And you can make his body a little bit more rounded, so he's a little bit more off the ground. So, but he's really cute, and it's a single loom, and we're going to make him in a couple different parts. We're going to do the tail first, and you'll need a toothpick or an extra hook to hold the tail. Then we're going to make this section to make the a little bit more poofy on the head, and you have to use another toothpick to put it to the side. So, and then we'll make the body and then the legs on the hook. So let's get started. You will need a single loom. I'm going to use this pattern with a little color in the middle and the color on the toes. If you want to use this, it's just every other band was a different color. So you have fuchsia, black, like that. So I'm going to use orange for the middle color and the pads, and orange eyes with the green body. Okay, so we're going to make the tail first, and I'm going to use the green and put it. It's going to be arrows facing down, and then the camera's to the right, and it's double bands. So we're going to go three bands across. Okay, then another band going diagonal. Then two more going regular. Okay, and then we're going to do just two pins. Okay, another two. We're just making his tail a little longer. Okay, another diagonal. Then going up. And then we're going to go two more going down. Okay, and now your cap and band is a single wrap three times around. Now we're going to make a little some structural bands to hold everything together. You need a single band, twist it upon itself, and then place it connecting these two pins. Another single band, twist upon itself, connect these two pins. Another single band connected upon itself right here. And then this is a single. You want to place it just as so and then wrap it around. It's going to be a single twist. Then twist it and place it just like that. So it's 1.5 twists. So it goes around. I'll show you again. So place it on the hook, twist it, and then place it back around just like that. Now we can start looming forward. Okay, now we're grabbing this band. And then the diagonal, then I'm going to loom all the way forward. Okay, now we're going to loom up to this point. Okay, now we're grabbing this band because it's on the top. And looming forward. Now roll the diagonal. And the last. Okay, now you can take this slowly off the hook. I'm going to just place it on my hook right now. This is when you need a spare hook or the toothpicks. So I'm going to grab my toothpicks and I'm going to place it right through to save these. Okay, and that's your tail. Okay, just like that. Okay, so now I'm going to make the... Okay, now we're going to go on a diagonal to go into the neck area. Then we're going to go another 2 pin bars down. This is the neck. Okay, now we're working on the top part of the body, which is right here. And I'm going to make a belly like this, but an orange. But if you're making the every other, you can just do the every other two. And there is an extension in the belly area because it's 4 pin bars wide in this little belly area. Okay, so I'm gonna do the green, the outside. And then I'm gonna work on the orange for the inside. And then another green on the side. Okay, so now I'm going to just work all the way down with green on the left side. I'm going too fast. You can slow down, put pause. Okay, now I'm working on the right side, the green. Okay, so now I'm going to work on the orange middle. And I'm going to place doubles going all the way down until this pin bar. Then I'm going to put a green right here at the end. Okay, so now I'm going to work on the middle extension to make him a little bit more wider in the middle. So I'm going to start right here. Take it to the poofy part of the head. So it's a part of the head that I'm going to place on later on. So use the same colors as the head that I'm using. Now, this one is black and fuchsia, but for the poofy part, I just used the fuchsia colors. So if you want your other colors to be darker, you can place that here too. So whatever you like, but I'm going to use the green and still double bands. I'm placing two there. And there, and then there, so it's straight across. Then we're going down to the middle pin. And then here to the middle pin. So your capping band will be a single wrapped three times around. And we're just going to loom everything forward and get a toothpick ready or another hook. So we're going to grab this one first. And go all the way up. Now we're going to grab this one. Up. Now grab this one. And all the way up. We'll take it off the loom. Grab my toothpick and place it through. And then save this for later, just like the tail. So now we can work on the body. And mine's going to be the green for the whole body. So it's double. And I'm going to place it right on the first pin to the right. And this is the head we're working on now. And then we're going to place another right here to this pin. And then we're going to work our way down. So everything is double. And if you're doing every other, you can work with that too. For here, I use the fuchsia for these two bands and fuchsia for here. And then I use black for here and black for here. And then I did every other. So do another double here, and then we're going to do another row here. Slow if this is new to you with the extensions. I'm going to work not on this pin, I'm going to work on this pin. I'm going to place a double band right on top, then another double band, working my way down. So I'm laying another row on top. Then I'm going to place another double on top here and not over here. So I'm going to make a little capping band here of orange because the color of my belly. Wrap it around three times. Okay, just like that. So you have one, two, three, four. Okay, on four bands on top, four double bands. Then I'm going to place little structural bands. It's a single, and I'm just going to place it right across the top. Another single, right across the top. Another single, right across the top. Single, across the top. Single, across the top. And then right here is a single twist, just like the other one, which is a single. Then I'm going to twist it halfway and place it like that. So it's a single, and then I twist it on top. Here, I'll show you again, just like before. Single twist, and right on top. Very easy. So we're going to loom this little extension. I'm not looming the bottom row. I'm only looming this top. So I'm going to go underneath that little capping band, grab the top bands that I put on there, and loom it forward. Then I'm going to grab just the top, loom it forward. Just the top, loom it forward, top, and then stop. Because this is not enough, this is a bottom. Okay, remember we only had these, the middle section. So we have one on the bottom here, one on the bottom here. Now we can grab this top little extension and pull it to the side. Top extension, pull to the side. Top extension, pull to the side, so it looks like this. Okay, now we can put the tail on here. So take your tail that you had before, you can take it off the holder, put the left side on this pin, put the middle here, and the right side on here.